Good afternoon. This weekend, our second collection is for retired religious. Please be as generous as possible. We will be decorating our church next Sunday after the 11 a.m. Mass. Please try to come and help. We are only asking for an hour of your time. Thank you. Good evening. Is the same today as it was over 2,000 years ago. Share what we have, do our jobs well, and be content with the gifts that God has given us. As we celebrate our liturgy today, let us ask God to help us see what changes we can make in our lives in order to be ready for him when he comes. Our gathering song is Awake, Awake, and Greet the New Morn, which can be found in the We Celebrate hymnal, number 489. Please stand as we begin our celebration.
Prepare ourselves to celebrate these Enable us, we pray, to attain the joys of so great a salvation and to celebrate them always with solemn worship and glad rejoicing. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Shout for joy, O daughter Zion. Sing joyfully, O Israel. Be glad and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has removed the judgment against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You have no further misfortune to fear. On that day, it shall be said to Jerusalem, "Fear not, O Zion. Be not discouraged. The Lord your God is in your midst, a mighty Savior. He will rejoice over you with gladness and renew you in his love. He will sing joyfully because of you, as one sings at festivals." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing our responsorial song, "Let Us See Your Kindness," which can be found on the yellow insert in the We Celebrate hymnal, number 7.
Lord, let us see your kindness.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. Your kindness should be known to all. The Lord is near. Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your heart and minds in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Second reading, rejoice,
Again, I say it, rejoice. What should we do? That question was asked of Jesus. They thought John was the Christ. And so we acknowledge in the third Sunday of Advent always that joy within our hearts, not to have anxiety about us or stress in our time of being ready for the coming of the Lord. Our hearts must be open. We need to have joy about us in getting ready to celebrate at Christmas the coming of the Lord and his coming again in glory and majesty that we await as we await his second coming. And so the question that they asked Jesus, what should we do? Maybe we need to ask that question, you and me. What should you do? What should I do as we await the coming of the Lord? And so we get ready in so many varied ways at this time. Decorating, trees go up, lights go up, cards go out, baking and getting ready. Yes, that's the joy and the spirit of the season. And that's what we are supposed to have within our hearts and our souls, and spiritually ready with joy, for the Lord is near. And so on this third Sunday of Advent, we always bless the Bambino, the baby Jesus. As you know, in Italy, Pope Francis, the Pope, blesses the Bambino on the third Sunday of Advent. And so some of you brought your baby Jesus with you here, and we're going to bless now the baby Jesus as we get ready to celebrate the Nativity, as we said in the opening prayer for this third Sunday of Advent, that we will be ready to celebrate the Nativity of the Lord shortly, as the baby will be once again renewed within our joy and our hearts and souls as we celebrate Christmas. Loving God, we ask your blessing upon the baby Jesus for our creche, our nativity, our mangers of Christmas. May Almighty God bless and come upon the Bambino, the baby Jesus, for Christmas, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. And all your baby Jesus at home, consider them all blessed now as we put them into our mangers of Christmas. Amen. We believe now in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father, through him all things. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our Savior was crucified on the cross of God, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. Advent, we look to the unequal generosity of God, attentive to our sisters and brothers in need.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For our church, that we may always heed John the Baptist's call to share what we have with those who have none, to act honorably and honestly, and to repent of our sins as we joyfully proclaim the coming of the reign of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That world leaders may look beyond past divisions and rivalries and work together to bring justice and peace, especially in areas beset by trauma and fear. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the people of the Americas may find in Our Lady of Guadalupe a model of compassion and kindness to those who are unable to offer anything material in return. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Fill all our prayers, spoken and unspoken, for the sick and homebound, and for all those in our special intention book near our cross. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who are suffering from loss at this time of year, that they may be comforted in their grief and find joy in God's love for all of us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who live with chronic illness, that in the care they receive from family, friends, and caregivers, that they may know the love of our Savior. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have died in Christ, for John Fostock, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for others we would like to remember. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for those people in Kentucky from the tornado that went through Kentucky, over 70 people killed, people, families torn apart. Here we're talking about joy. We pray for those who are suffering greatly, loss of lives, tragedy, loss of homes, and so forth in Kentucky, from the tornadoes. We pray for them and remember them, suffering people. We pray to the Lord. Generous God, bestow upon us the grace to understand your divine will so that we can answer the gospel plea, what should we do? Bless us in our efforts to carry out your will through your Son, our Lord, whose coming we proclaim in joyous expectation through Christ our Lord.
Please join in singing our hymn during the preparation of the gifts, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, which can be found in the We Celebrate hymnal, number 496.
Come, O come, Emmanuel, and as the captive.
Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all time. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
The mystery of faith.
more the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, all the clergy, religious, and faithful people. Remember John Fostock. Also, our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. We remember Robert Doran and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word of my soul. Thank you. sustenance may cleanse us of our faults and prepare us for the coming feast through Christ our Lord. Just a reminder, as you're leaving the church, at the doors is a calendar, so take the religious calendar to have in your home. It's important to have a religious calendar, and so we thank the Mary Funeral Home, who always provides the calendar every year for us to have in our homes. So take them as you're leaving. They're at the doors of the church. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of Christ. Have a great evening.
A season of light, which will be found in the We Celebrate the Hope, number 500.